So, first question on everybody's mind. Yesterday was heavy, but it's football. Football is cruel in its own way. But looking past that game, Nigerians have reacted. They said on social media, they said they were vexed with the result, this and that. What should Nigerians expect from the team for the return leg? And what lessons did we learn from yesterday's all-four draw?
If they say that they are vexed about the match and the result, they are right. We are all vexed about it. We cannot accept such a result when you lead 4-0 and you have 4-1 in the half-time. The first half was one of the best we never made together. So what happened? That the team collapsed in the second time. We are now trying to analyze. For me already, what is sure, the facts are that we had a very bad preparation. The players arriving very late, even the day before the match, in the evening. So we had only one collective training together. Physically and mentally, they lost energy in second half. Hot weather coming for the players who are coming from Europe especially. And then a collapse came, and in the end came this injury of our main striker. And so everybody said it's bad luck. So I think mentally, especially our young players, are not strong enough for these kind of games. So we have to check, we have to not to forget that it was very good in the first time. We cannot forget, but the result is here. The result is 1 point. We need another 3 points now to qualify. We want to do it there, in Freetown. Everybody is in a big determination. Everybody is vexed. Nobody slept. So we are trying to forget a little bit now in the training and also in the meeting we will do. We will see again the crucial situations on video, speak about the mistakes, and then I'm sure they will react because I know my team. I know what we can do. They showed it in the first half. If we can maintain the energy for the second half, we can do it. Even if I always knew that it's a good team. You didn't believe me yourself when I said to everybody, that's a good team, the Sierra Leone. We watched them. It's a good team. But I think in the halftime, the players believe it's finished. But if it was not finished, it's a good lesson to everybody, to the staff, to the players, and we have to react. I can promise you they will react. If they are lucky or not, I cannot promise you, but they will fight and we go there to win the match.
What's the fitness level of your players? Because we have seen that Bonaventure, Dennis, is not training, and also that of Osimhen is understood. And also, we have seen that of Chukwueze, only you were just going around. So just tell us the mental state and the fitness level of the players right now.
Yes, the two players I put out because of injury, it was Balogun, who had a little knock. He's okay, he could do a little training today. It's not painless, but he will be okay. Then Osimhen probably will be out. He has a luxation of the shoulder, so I think it will be very difficult for him to be there in Freetown. Dennis got a little injury in the last training session. So his ankle is swollen and he cannot play, he only can run. And the last one is Chukwueze, has a pain in the groin and could only walk a little bit this morning, but we hope to get him back for the next game.
All right, coach, a lot of people are asking why Kevin Akpoguma has to play in the right back position when you have other players that can play that position comfortably well and who are natural right backs. Players like Tyrone Igboe, players like Aino and Shehu Doikemlet. What was the decision behind you using Kevin in the right back, knowing fully well that he's played almost the bulk of his career as a center and defender?
Yes, at first Kevin is also playing sometimes right back in his club. I'm in a good place sometimes to follow what he's doing in his club, and he played a lot of games on the right back position. So it's not a new one for him. We need it against these tall guys who likes to play in the air. Players who are good with the head. He's much better in the air, like and defender like Ola Aina or Tyron. We have a little problem with the head. So that was one of the reasons I saw that Kevin Akpoguma was one of the best defenders yesterday. So I don't believe that was a problem for the team. The problem was the team were other mistakes, were some individual mistakes, losing balls too easily, not being in position behind, not being on the man-to-man exactly. And we will analyze it again this afternoon. And yes, but I'm very happy about the performance of